Good evening, YouTube. So in the previous video, I showed you my second trip up this old road that shows up on the 1895 USGS Topo Map. I first found out about these maps, I think in early 2020. This was the first road I went to see if I could find it, and I actually did. That was in early 2020, and I went up here a ways and got up to about this point. Anyway, in 2022, I had discovered the hillshade maps. I didn't have them properly calibrated, but at least I could look at the hillshade maps so I could see that this road actually continued on past where I stopped down here. And so I made it up to about this point, and I ran into just some impenetrable brush. This year, I went up in June, and I had the properly calibrated hillshade maps. I was a little better able to get around up here because I could see how to get from one piece of the road over to another piece without having to go through all the brush. So that worked fairly well until I got buried in another wall of impenetrable brush. I just couldn't get anywhere, and so I came back down again. And I was basically ready to throw in the towel on this old road because I've been up there twice and I got stopped by brush. And you get in this brush, it's all the way from ground level to 10 feet high. You can't see through it. You can't see over it. You can't do anything. It just stops you dead in your tracks. Anyway, back in 2020, when I first saw that old road, one of the things I did was I came over here to Google Maps. On the basic map screen, you can see the creek, you can see the old canyon trail here, like that's where it crosses Stevens Creek, but there's nothing else here. Load the terrain layer, you can kind of make out that landslide area, but there's not a lot there. And I remember 3 years ago, I looked at the aerial view. I can see where the trail is because they overlay that on the satellite data, but I can't see the old road. You know, it's like, well, these satellite or aerial imagery just doesn't help up here because all you see are the tops of the trees, and I need to see what's on the ground. And that's why when I found the hillshade maps, I thought, oh, this is really cool. Now, one thing that is rather interesting is this is the 3D view. And with this, you can really see how that bench is set up here. It looks like this is probably a trace of the old road coming up here. It hits this landslide area, goes back over here, and comes up this canyon here, and then it makes a switchback and comes around onto this bench that you can clearly see there. It's not level, but it's a lot less steep than the rest of the canyon. And in fact, if we zoom out a bit here, you can see this whole bench area is probably landslide debris that came down from higher up here. I'm thinking this might actually be landslide deposit, and it's probably the same rock. I think this is like a sandstone here. It's very crumbly, and it's probably the same rock all the way to the top of the ridge. And this is what is creating the landslide now. But I bet 10,000-20,000 years ago, this here probably came down. But this is neat, but I can't do this up here. There's no data signal up here. Yeah, anyway, like I was saying, I had looked at this imagery layer, and it's like, well, it's not of any use because I can't see anything on the ground. All I see are the treetops. So I basically had given up on that, except, do you notice anything here? There is a big meadow up on this bench. And I think I had seen that before, but I kind of forgot about it. But there's a big grassy meadow up there, and I've been up here twice and I've never seen any open grass up there. And so that got me thinking, where was I relative to this meadow? Because I've never seen this meadow up there. And I was trying to figure out, how can I find out where that grass is. And then I came back over here. This is the USGS National Map Viewer. I remember they had an imagery layer right there. And there's the same location. Here's the slide. And here's this grassy meadow. And I thought, okay, how about I turn on the hillshade layer and I can switch back and forth and kind of see, like, oh, there's a road that comes up through here, it looks like. You can kind of make that out. You can see the road up this canyon here. If I flip it on and off a few times, you know, you can do that flip back and forth, but then I remembered they have this transparency feature. So I can fade this out and look at this. Look at that. That is just amazing right there. You can just fade the hillshade layer out enough so you can see through it. And now you can see here's the roads right here. Here's the road I came up on. I had come up this way, and then here's this gully here where it got really wet and brushy. So I cut across over to here. Then I came up to this road that runs to the southwest. So I was up here someplace and I'd come down here trying to get to this thing here, whatever that is. I'm thinking that's probably an old building foundation, but I just couldn't get anywhere near this. Last year I'd come in this way and got blocked by a bunch of brush. And this year I tried to come in this way and I got blocked. This whole thing just seems to be surrounded by brush. Came over this way to get to this area here. Had I had this layer here, I was just that far away from grass. Or I was here, I could have just come across to here. It was literally like 15 feet, maybe 5 meters away from an open grassy meadow. But I didn't know it because I couldn't see anything. Anyway, let me switch over to OsmAnd on my phone and I'll show you this actually works.
Okay, YouTube, here's OsmAnd. We can look at the settings here. So under configure map, so I have the map source, that's the base map, is my aerial view, which I called CT for canyon trail. And then this is the area of the landslide. And this is the third map. And then down here, I have overlay map is CT slide 2. Let's zoom in a little bit. Here you can see I've got the overlay map. And if I make it a little more transparent, it's hard to get the slider here. And right there, look at that. I can do the exact same thing that I can do on the USGS web viewer application. While I'm up here, I can actually see that. So that is going to be really neat. And I can zoom in, and the aerial data isn't super high resolution, but the idea is I can see where the grass is. So if I get up into this area like I did last time, I can see which way to go to get to the open grass. But yeah, I can just fade the hillshade in and out and look for grassy areas, or I can even look for different color tree tops, because I think the darker shade of green are the mature oak trees. The lighter colored green is more of the younger trees and brush. And then the one you really want to avoid is this sort of muddy green color that's right there in the center on the side of the landslide, because that stuff is just horrible brush. Just wanted to show you that running on OsmAnd. Proof of concept, looks like it works. Now I probably won't be able to get up to this area until next spring, but I now have a plan of attack. I've got the map here. It's ready to go when I fire it up maybe next April. So yeah, I'll put a link to how to create these maps in the video description. And as always, thanks for watching.